Uncle Ben?
Yes, Peter?
Why do bad guys do bad things?
That's a good question, kid. I don't know.
It's 7 a.m. What are you doing here?
May said she needed help getting ready for the yard sale. I had nothing better to do.
Why did May put this in here?
The glove is signed by Derek Jeter. May thought you could make a lot of money off of it.
I don't know. I can't sell this glove. One day, me and Ben went to a Yankees game, and we were in the stands. It was a great day. We had lots of popcorn. We didn't tell May. May is kind of on a health kick. And in the line for popcorn, we just so happened to run into one of the best players in the league. We really pestered him, but he ended up signing it. And I don't know, Ben was so happy that day. And I can't let this go.
Yeah, I understand.
Things are going to improve a lot and in a hurry. Let's start with crime. I'm going to clean up New York City. Crime rates are off the charts. Courtrooms are corrupt. Police are largely in pockets of the mobsters. Supervillains are running loose. The Avengers are too busy fighting foreign conflicts to take care of things at home. When I'm elected mayor, I am going to clean up these streets. I'll start by stationing armed Oscorp security drones in at-risk communities. That way we get to save the lives of the few good cops left, and most importantly, save taxpayer dollars.
Don't tell Harry, but his father is a complete fascist nutjob.
Yeah, Mr. Osborn does have a few screws loose.
His policies literally punish the poor and keep the rich safe. He's an asshole.
Yeah, so he's every other politician.
That's for sure. There's a scary amount of people willing to vote for him, though.
People are scared. I mean, just look at the crime rate in this city alone. Osborn's making people feel safe. I'm not surprised a lot of people are going to vote for him.
Hey, Harry's in the park. Do you want to go meet him?
Yeah, sure.
Also, bring your suit, just in case.
So, what did you think of that playlist I made you?
Well, it was a nice gesture, but there was like 4 Weezer songs on it.
Come on, Weezer is awesome. What's wrong with Weezer?
Yeah, it's awesome if you're like a 20-year-old incel with a god complex and a man bun.
Okay, listen, plenty of cool people listen to Weezer.
Yeah, name one.
I mean, I'm Exhibit A, and then there's,
Okay, you don't count it as an example, and you're really struggling here, aren't you?
Tony Stark! I bet you Tony Stark listens to Weezer.
Tony Stark?
Yeah!
Weezer.
That's exactly what he's listening to when he's flying around shooting people. It's Beverly Hills, and he's like... No.
Anyways, so, how's your time being Spider-Man?
It's going alright.
Well, give yourself some credit. I mean, you haven't hospitalized anyone in over a year, so that's an improvement?
I don't really think we should be celebrating that.
Look, I get why you're angry. If I lost my father the way you lost Ben, I'd probably feel the same way.
Yeah.
And you're improving, and that's something to be proud of.
Yeah, I guess.
So there I was in the middle of Germany, chilling with the homie Wilhelm, having an absolute blast and the best time of our lives. We're downing Jägermeister, and everything after that, it was an absolute blur. All I remember is limo, German weed, beautiful German girls. I'm sorry, I'm a little nervous. I haven't done this before. Dad, what are you doing here? Terrible, terrible ride home. Crying. Pain. And now I'm here.
Wow, sounds like you had quite the trip.
It was nothing interesting. What'd you guys do?
I'm just playing drums for my band.
Web design.
I gotta say, guys, it's really great to see you guys again, you know. Just been so busy, you know, making money and changing the world and doing great things and making a mad out of myself that I just completely forgot about my best friends. So, it's great to see you guys.
Okay. Wow.
What's up, MaxiPad? Listen, Flash, I really don't have time for this today.
I'm just here to help you with that little posture issue you have.
What issue?
Come on, man. You gotta be shitting me. You know, Pete, I really thought he'd stop after we beat the shit out of him. Remember that?
Yeah. Hey, Osborn, look. It's that little bitch, Parker.
He's just mad because his uncle got capped.
Flash, dude, that's way too far.
Don't be a pansy, Osborn. He could take it. Right, Parker?
Flash, knock it off.
What? Your father's gonna sue my father? It's just a laugh, man.
Hey, dude, stop.
I don't want to fight you, Flash. I wouldn't want to fight me neither.
Get the hell off me.
Are you going to help me with them?
What, Flash? I thought you could take them.
Dude. What the fuck?
I just knocked out Flash.
Yeah?
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, let's go.
Flash is such an asshole. You know, I think he only hangs around with me because I have money, and that sucks. I just want to say I'm sorry for teasing you. It wasn't cool. And when Flash brought up your Uncle Ben, that was crossing the line, man. I'm really sorry.
It's okay. I forgive you.
Thank you. Well, it's nice to finally meet you, Peter Parker.
And it's nice to meet you,
Wow, it's really nice to meet someone who doesn't know who I am. Harry Osborn.
Well, you can't solve everything with your fists, Harry.
Come on, Maxie Pad.
Just leave him alone, Flash.
You got some big cojones on you, bud.
It's cojones, first of all. And dude, he wasn't doing anything to you.
You're doing great, Peter. Keep it up.
Son of a bitch.
You all right, man?
Nothing I can't handle. Thanks.
No problem.
How's your mom holding up?
Hospital let her go a few days ago. It's not looking good.
I'm sorry to hear that, man. If you guys need any help with money or anything, just feel free to let me know. I'd be more than happy to help you.
Well, I'm starting a new job tomorrow, so I should be okay for the money. Hey, you want to hang out tomorrow?
Yeah, we can hang out tomorrow if you want, man.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. Hey, Max, we'll hang out tomorrow, okay? I'll see you tomorrow. I gotta go.
Holy cow! Hello, Mr., Dr. Octopus?
Oh. Wow. My first ever supervillain.
Pair of pajamas and some cheap gymnastic classes don't make you an Avenger, boy. Go home before you get hurt.
Chill out. What's the problem here?
Cybertech is the problem. Everyone working there deserves what's coming to them.
What did you do?
I simply took back what is mine. They abused me, berated me, and then took credit for the arms I created. And then they had the nerve to fire me? Is it too much to ask for a little recognition?
I'm sorry to hear that. And you're right. You deserve all the credit. And I gotta say, those arms are like... Wow, they're really impressive. It's just... No offense, and I mean no offense at all. You're going about this terribly.
Leave now, before I tear the flesh off your bones.
Yikes, that line must go over really well with the ladies. Don't be mad. It's your fault for working at Cybertech in the first place. They don't even cover dental. Ah! These arms are awesome.
You don't understand. My work was everything I had.
Gwen? Not bad, Stacy.
world keeps pushing and pushing me. How much more can I be expected to take before I completely snap? They can't just take everything from me!
I know what you mean, bro. I felt the same way when they kicked me out of Broadway. I'm starting to think I might have overshadowed the other actors a bit too much. Society, am I right?
I've been pushed aside my entire life, Quentin. Always working in the shadows, never reaching the light. I just want this world to realize I exist. I want some damn recognition!
I've got an idea. I know a way you can get your recognition.
Do enlighten me, Quentin.
I got some boys who are tired of the way the world's been treating them. They feel the same as you and me. And they ain't exactly law-abiding citizens either.
I fail to see where you're going with this, Quentin.
I don't know about you, but I'm sure as shit tired of being pushed around by the world. I say we never get pushed around again. Look outside the window. You'll see one of those caped losers flying by. With that kind of power, they don't have to take shit from anybody. What if we had that kind of power?
Yes, Quentin. And where do you propose we get that kind of power?
Think, Otto. Look at the mechanical arms you've made. Think of the power you now have. Nobody's going to be messing with you after today's little fiasco. You can give people like us that kind of power. You're brilliant, Otto.
You think so?
Well, yeah, of course. So, what do you think? Personally, I'm kind of in the market for some illusion superpowers. Like, the cop signal over there. But I'm actually over there, and I can be all like, pow, pow, pow.
Yes, well, I'm not convinced. What if we ended up giving powers to some truly terrible people?
Listen to yourself, Otto. There are no bad people. Just people stuck in shitty situations. I mean, according to the media, you and I are bad people. You saw how they talked about you on TV. We could finally give people the freedom they've always wanted. With power like that, we can do whatever we want. We can finally be free.
I can't believe I'm saying this, Quentin. But I think you might be right. The most corrupted people in this society are the ones who hold all the power. But I can give power to the powerless. I can liberate us.
And the people in need will recognize and love you for it.
Yes! We can bond over our shared scars that this life has inflicted upon us. We can bathe in the power I have bestowed upon us all. We can reclaim our lives!
Exactly, Otto. Buddy, you can make those mechanical arms. You can make other insane tech. You can make superpowers.
Do you have any potential customers in mind?
Right, well, first and foremost, there's me, obviously. I know a guy, what was his name? Flint Marco. I'm sure he'd be interested in sticking it to the man. A bank robber named Herman Schultz. I'm sure he would love some superpowers. There was this Russian guy, too. I did business with him before. I forget his name. Craven or something. I'm sure he would love some superpowers.
Very well, Quentin. Tell them to come in. Let's get to work.
She shot me, she shot me, bang, bang, she shot me. She shot me, she shot me, bang, bang, she shot me. She shot me, she shot me, bang, bang, she shot me. She shot me, she shot me, bang, bang. There she goes again, the dope is Ethiopian. In other words, she came through exploding in the podium. Dynamite, Napoleon, like sodium mixed with petroleum. Slowly but surely, she was walking toward me. Cut the convo short, cause she had to wake up early. But continuing the story, don't worry, she gave me.
With love in
she was
eye.
Walking around with a loaded shotgun.
Hey, buddy, I don't think that purse belongs to you. Ooh. Wait. Who owns this purse? Does anyone own this purse? Anyone? Purse stolen. Anyone own it? Does anyone own this purse?
Good morning, New York City, and welcome back to the Daily Beagle Morning Report. I'm your host, Frederick Foswell, and let's spill the beans. Today marks the 2-year anniversary of the first appearance of Spider-Man. Let's take a look and see what the citizens of New York have to say about our friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
We're looking for superheroes. We're superhero spotters. Record them and stuff, you know. Alright, well, sorry, what was it about? Spider-Man. In my opinion, he's not a real hero. People like getting videos of him. I don't think he's a real hero. Really, all he does is just acrobatics in the air. He swings around. It's not really substance, you know? I mean, you got actual heroes like Doctor Strange, Iron Man, Captain America, you know, the real ones. And then I think this one's detrimental to the city of New York.
Spider-Man? A menace? No. He's all about the community. All about the community. I was there for his first fight. I got him big. I'm just gonna say that. I posted that. Went insane. But he's all about the community. He's just the community loves him and all that. He helps the old ladies cross the street. He does everything. Avengers Tower? Tony Stark made that off of money. Spider-Man's coming from the bottom. From the bottom! He's going to the top. He's going to be the best one. Oh, and come to my fan club. We meet every Monday.
Mr. Osborn, what is your opinion on the Spider-Man?
Hey, I'm a huge fan of our friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. He's cleaning up the streets. He's a citizen who's willing to put his foot down and take on the bad guys.
And what do I think of this Spider-Man guy? Well, he's a menace. He's a disgrace to law and order and the people of this city. I want him off the streets. He's a criminal, I tell you. He's an Avengers reject, and he's a menace.
Seems like opinions about the local wall crawler are largely divided. After the break, everything you need to know about J. Jonah Jameson's new book, Lunatics in Tights and How to Stop 'Em.
Welcome back to the Daily Bugle Report. My name is J. Jonah Jameson, and I'm here to spill the beans. Today, a psycho with robotic tentacles attacked and burned down the Cybertech Industries building in Queens. The perpetrator has not yet been caught, but has been identified as Dr. Otto Octavius. Luckily, there were no fatalities in the incident, as the scientists in the building were saved by a mysterious man in red and blue. We'll have more on that after the break.
Those bastards! All they're doing is talking about what Spider-Man did, not what Reed Richards did to deserve this!
What exactly did Reed Richards do?
Welcome to Cybertech Industries, where the future is already in the past. My name is Dr. Reed Richards, but you already knew that by now. My face is all over TV constantly, and if you missed it, I'm sorry. Would you like to see something cool? Because I have something very interesting for you to see. Some would say it's cool. Introducing omnidirectional cybernetic Kevlar arms, but in my free time, sometimes I call them Ock arms for short. It's just easier to say. Using signals from a brain chip, these bullet heat and waterproof arms assist the user in lifting objects of extraordinary weights. These arms are capable of lifting and carrying up to 50,000 pounds, which you didn't know is already a lot of pounds. Now, you're probably wondering, who is to be credited for all of these incredible inventions? Spoilers. It's me.
He took the credit for Dr. Octavius' work. He was my mentor. And now Cybertech is destroyed, there's a warrant out for Otto's arrest, and I have no job. I was his assistant. That was how I was paying my mom's medical bills. And it's gone. And it's all Richard's fault.
Well, I would say it's Otto Octavius' fault because he's the one who blew up the building.
I guess, but... Well, I wouldn't be able to sit there if someone destroyed my life's work too. So I know where he's coming from.
So what are you gonna do now? For money?
Well, I'm out of options. The economy's screwed, nobody's hiring. So, I'm gonna put my chemistry skills to use. I've been cooking up oxy last night, Heisenberg style. It sells really well in the streets.
You're joking. You're gonna sell drugs to pay for your mom's medical bills?
Yeah, man. I'm a chemist, and my uncle had some coca plants at his house. So I grabbed some leaves, took them home, diluted the cornstarch and talcum powder, add a little thing here, a little thing there, and boom! I called it Max's Brew.
Dude, put that away!
Alright, man, alright. It wasn't for you anyway.
Max, what are you doing? If you're caught with that, you're gonna be arrested. If you sell it, you're going to ruin more people's lives. The city's in a rough spot enough as it is.
What other hope have I got? It costs more than that, Peter.
What? No, Max, I'm not trying to buy your drugs. Just consider it from me and May, for your mom.
No, man, I can't take your charity. You and May are struggling with rent as is.
Just take the money, man. It's not much. I want to give this to you.
Thanks. I'm not really used to people helping me. These guys are stealing crypto now? Times are changing, man.
Max, I gotta go.
Dude, we were gonna play PlayStation? I brought my own controller and everything, come on.
I just remembered, I made commitments with Aunt May. I'm really sorry, man.
Come on, man. I need this.
Just let yourself out. We'll be in touch, we'll hang out soon. And don't sell that stuff, dude, please. You're gonna get yourself arrested.
Woo!
Got it, right?
Yeah, I got it. $50 million on this thing in cryptocurrency. What's up for life, Flint? I can get my family back. You can help your daughter. We won, man. We won.
No, I gotta say, I was pretty skeptical at first when you told me to meet up with that Octavius guy. Man, these powers are already paying off.
That's a good idea.
Hey, guys. The bank is that way if you're looking for a spot to return all that stolen money. That would be awful nice of you to do. You know, you two commit more crimes than a character from a Martin Scorsese movie. I'm surprised you guys haven't made it to the big screen yet.
I got this.
Well, that's new. My leg was just inside of you. That's disgusting. Where did you get superpowers to, man? Ah, forget it. Oh, son of a biscuit! Come on, Shocker. Mask is a pain in the web spinner.
So are we done?
No, we're not done yet. I'm just catching some air. Just give me a second.
Convert this to cash, wire me my card, alright?
Got it.
Don't lose it. Oh yeah, don't worry about me. I'll just take a bus or something. Jesus, Flint. Stay down, kid. You're batting out of your league.
No. Guys like you can't win. You can't just take from innocent people and get away with it.
I got good reasons. You wouldn't understand. Look, kid. You're doing what you think is right. And I admire that, okay? But just stay out of it. All right? Just step aside.
No. I'm never stepping aside again.
See you around, kid.
The criminals who robbed the Hudson Valley Bank today need to be apprehended and severely punished. Do these maniacs think they can get away with stealing taxpayer dollars? If they do, they're gravely mistaken. The robotics division at Oscorp has finalized the security drones, and they are ready to be deployed. As a citizen of this great city, I say it is time to put our foot down. Enough questions.
You got the money?
Obviously.
Now, hey, you don't need to worry about anything in that package there, man. That's all pure. It's clean. I made it myself, actually, so you know it's not laced. There's nothing goofy in there or anything like that, you know?
You made this batch right here.
Yep.
So this wasn't given to you by anyone. You're the cook.
No, I made that all myself. Don't mean to brag, but I'm a hell of a chemist. And I actually had a job down to Cybertech before Doc Ock attacked and just wiped it all out. So now I'm here on my own, running my own business, you know what I'm saying?
So you're not associated with the Magia or Silvermane or any of the other gangs?
Yep, it's all me and only me here, brother. I'm just doing this to get some money for my mom's medical bills, you know?
This mask is a ventilation system. You don't want to let that internal heat build up within you. You gotta let yourself air out a bit after using your powers. Without this mask, your powers won't work effectively, so you gotta let yourself cool down after power usage.
So I need to wear this to make my powers work, right?
Hey, I mean, it's not that bad. You know, if you don't wear the mask, smoke will just build up in your lungs a bit. But that's a small price to pay for what the doc gave you.
I guess so. I'll send the payment to the engineer. Give him my praise.
Sure thing. I'll make sure the engineer receives your good words. Well, it's been a pleasure doing business with you.
Evening.
Who was that? What did they sell you, Raxton?
Could I get a hello at least? Whatever happened to you, Daredevil?
That's not who I am anymore.
Good. I won't feel bad about this now.
Who sold you those powers?
I ain't telling you shit.
We'll see.
Agent Murdock, how can I help you today?
I'm not an agent. I'm the man without fear.
The man without fear? Yeah, I'm not calling you that. Daredevil rolled off the tongue a lot easier.
I just saw two more, Garrick. Took down one of them. One had some kind of fire-manipulating ability, the other was Mysterio, the one we've been seeing a lot recently. That's two new supervillains today.
Five, actually. Two men just robbed a bank recently. One with sand powers, and the other with shockwave-emitting gauntlets. What a sentence. And Russian assassin Sergei Kravnov just acquired a prototype of the super soldier serum. I think all these criminals are getting their powers from the same source.
I took down the one with fire manipulation. Now we only gotta worry about four. He did mention something about some kind of power broker. I assume that's the source.
It's likely. Agent, it is imperative that these supervillains are stopped. We can't have the public finding out about some lunatics who obtained powers. It will lead to mass hysteria, conspiracies, and I don't want to be the one telling Director Fury he's been invited to be a guest on InfoWars.
Understood. I'll take care of this.
Oh, no. I don't think so. We're not giving you this mission.
What do you mean?
Fury wants you on legal duties after that last Avengers fiasco. Besides, we need a real hero to deal with these villains. Someone who embodies our red, white, and blue ideals. Someone who represents our intolerance against injustice. Someone who, when the people of this country are faced with a threat that they cannot control, will look towards in comfort, if you will.
All right, then. So who are you thinking?
Wow, great catch, Peter. We'll make a professional out of you in no time.
Matt Murdock, attorney at law. You may want to have a seat. We have a lot to talk about, Spider-Man.
Listen, buddy, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I think you got the wrong house. I am not Spider-Man.
Cut the bullshit, kid. I'm with S.H.I.E.L.D. We've been watching you for a while.
Whoa. S.H.I.E.L.D.? Like, Strategic Homeland Intervention?
Yes, I know what S.H.I.E.L.D. stands for.
And you said you were an attorney, right? Is Spider-Man in some kind of legal trouble that I don't know about?
Well, not yet, but you're getting there.
Okay, so why are you here?
This is Sergei Kravinov. He's an ex-KGB assassin from Russia, but was exiled from his country when his profession turned to his obsession, and he began hunting humans for sport.
Huh. Sounds like an interesting character.
He never was a S.H.I.E.L.D. concern, that is, until yesterday. Kraven managed to get his hands on a prototype super soldier serum. It made him incredibly powerful, with agility, strength, and stamina, similar to the power of Captain America.
So you want me to take this guy down?
Not just him. I assume you're familiar with the Sandman?
Yeah. Are they related?
In the past 2 days, there's been a surge of superpowered criminals showing up all over New York. S.H.I.E.L.D. currently knows of four of them. There's Kravinov, Flint Marko, a.k.a. the Sandman, notorious bank robber Herman Schultz, and ex-Broadway actor turned criminal Quentin Beck. I believe there's a connection here. I believe we have a power broker in New York City.
So why are you coming to me about this?
The other Avengers are busy. S.H.I.E.L.D. is dealing with a foreign conflict in Latveria, and they need me as their representative. You're the only hero this city has left. You need to get to the bottom of this. Stop the supervillains and find the broker. I'll get Nova to watch over your work.
Listen, I'm really flattered you guys thought of me for this mission. Truly, I am. This is an honor. But I just don't think I'm the right choice for this. I mean, if you guys have been watching me as close as you say you've been watching me, then you should know of everything I've done.
Yes, we know all about the criminals you've hospitalized and punished. We also know that you've been trying to clean up your act. You've been pulling your punches. How admirable.
Thanks?
We don't need that kind of hero for this. We need someone to stop these villains immediately, even if it means breaking a few bones. They're dangerous, and compassion is out of the question. Don't try to understand them. These people are too far gone. The safety of the innocent is our top concern. I know you know what I'm talking about. Do you understand? Glad we're on the same page. Well, good luck, Spider-Man. Inside that file is all the information that I've gathered on those criminals. Nova will be in touch soon.
Yeah, no, I'll look into these guys and everything, but, there's a lot of them, and how do I contact?
Typical.
Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah, supervillains, Gwen, and a lot of them. I could barely handle Ock, he almost killed me.
So what are you gonna do?
I'll do my best. I'm just scared.
What are you so afraid of? Besides supervillains, of course.
The night Uncle Ben died, there was a guy robbing the store. He was making off with the money, and he ran right past me. Everyone told me, they said, stop him, and I didn't. That same night, that robber killed Uncle Ben. That guilt, that lack of responsibility, the lack of action is why I became Spider-Man, so no one would ever have to endure what I've endured. But when I found the guy who killed him, I beat him to a near inch of his life. He was hospitalized for the next month. This mission that I'm given now, the supervillains, all of it, I'm really scared that side of me will be brought out again, and I just don't want that to happen.
Well, maybe try fighting them in a non-violent, non-confrontational way. Maybe instead of using your fists, you can try to reason with them and maybe try to understand them.
I can't do that, Gwen. These people, these supervillains, they're not people. They use their powers to hurt others.
Sounds familiar, doesn't it?
I know, and I've been trying to fight it.
Then fight it. Look, I know the guilt can be tough to carry, but the only person that can forgive you is yourself. The choice is yours, Peter. There's so much pain in this world. Don't add to it. Be the hero this world deserves, Peter.
Okay, yeah, no, I can totally do this. I can totally do this. How many of the supervillains are there again? There's four. We have Sandman, Mysterio, Kraven, and Shocker. And I got my ass kicked by Doc Ock. But yeah, no, four. That's no problem at all. I'll just take them one at a time. And that lawyer, Matt Murdock guy, said that Nova was gonna help me. Yeah, 2v4, no, I can totally do this. I'm not worried at all. I got this. I got this. I got this. Right after school, I'm gonna put the suit on, and I go look for Mysterio, and then that Murdock will be like, "Oh, Peter, you did such a great job! Wow, you're such a good New York hero!" Hello?
Spider-Man, how's it going today, bro?
I assume this is Nova, right?
You know it. Nice to meet you, brother.
Yeah, nice to meet you too, man. It's always good to talk with other superheroes, you know?
Alright, look, so I heard Murdock gave you a mission, and apparently I'm supposed to be babysitting you, but listen, I'm a bit preoccupied with this Zandarian-Kree conflict, so I'm not gonna have time to help you with the few lunatics with superpowers.
Okay, yeah, you know, that's understandable.
Alright, well, I'm gonna deal with that, and if my schedule clears up, then I'll blast by. Cool.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Alright, sick. Well, I'll see you around, Spider-Man.
Okay, yeah, sure. You know, the help would be nice, because I'm kind of facing a bunch of supervillains right now. Looks like I'm on my own for this one.
That's the problem with you, Harry. You don't focus on what's important.
Guitar is important to me. My friends, they're important to me.
Where are they gonna get you? You need good grades, a work ethic, money. But you've gotta wanna earn it.
You don't understand.
What don't I understand?
Forget it, okay?
Ah, Mr. Parker, how are we today?
Doing pretty good, Mr. Osborn. How about yourself?
Well, I'd be doing a lot better if Harry hadn't gotten suspended from school for fighting. I bet Peter never gets in fights.
He'd be surprised.
Really, Peter? I'd never take you for the type. How are the grades?
grades aren't bad. How's the campaign doing?
It's going great, Peter. The polls are predicting a win in my favor. At this point, I'm not even concerned about the election. I'm more concerned about what I'm going to do as mayor. New York will be a paradise when I'm done.
Tough act to follow.
So, what made you want to run for mayor?
I lost my wife a few years ago. Some punk kid just got his license and decided to down a few before he got behind the wheel. Nobody should have to go through that kind of pain. That's why I'm running. I want to stand up for this city.
Well, Spider-Man's doing the city some good too, Dad.
I know. That's why I'm willing to pay him $100,000 to endorse me for the election.
What?
$100,000. Spider-Man is the number one superhero in this city now that Daredevil's gone AWOL. Plus, we share similar philosophies on how the criminals of New York should be treated. They deserve to be punished. With Spider-Man at my side, I can't help but win this election.
That's a lot of money.
Well, look who you're talking to.
Well, it was really nice catching up with you guys, but I gotta go, so I'll see you later.
Do you want to hang out later?
Yeah, sure. You can just drop over to my house. Aunt May will let you in. Just don't worry about it, man. I'll see you later.
Alright. See you later, man.
Cheers, Peter. Why can't you be more like him?
Yeah, I got the money. Don't worry about it. It's... Well, what do you mean?
Sorry, Max. We did all we could do.
Look, I'm sorry. Whatever I did to you, I'm so sorry. You ruined my career! You were the reason I was kicked off of Broadway! Do you even realize the power your petty reviews have? Well, now I have the power now. Wait, I remember you. You're Quentin Beck. You played Daddy Zuko in Greece. You were awful! You're gonna regret saying that. Hey, Beck. You know, I actually kind of liked you in Greece. I thought you were pretty good. It's this whole new Mysterio part. It doesn't suit you at all. Spider-Man, you know, for someone who calls himself a hero, you and I have more in common than meets the eye.
You know, you're right. I can't really sing either.
I've prepared a little performance for you, Spider-Man. Original monologue and everything.
That's awesome, buddy. If you want, you can perform behind the bars of the local police station. I'm sure the other inmates would love a performance by you.
Mysterio presents Spider-Man's Enlightenment.
Am I supposed to be expecting something?
I'm showing you the truth, Spider-Man. You're no better than us. We're all just people. We all live on the same planet, but the world won't give us a break. Surely you know what I'm talking about.
So, that doesn't mean you get to destroy and ruin other people's lives just because your life sucks?
My friends and I are just willing to cross lines that you don't want to cross. You're no different from us. Why help the oppressors when you can join the oppressed?
Yeah, you guys are just a few clowns short of a circus, all right.
Why are you doing this? Did you lose someone close to you?
Watch it. I'm not afraid to hurt you.
Fine. Be the hero. Increase the number of corpses already on your conscience.
I'm trying to make. Be the same as the rest of this horrible world. I'll see you around, Spider-Man.
Yo, dude, you're never gonna believe what I... Hey, Peter.
Hey, Harry. What are you doing here?
You said that we were gonna hang out. May let me in. Is that... Are you Spider-Man?
No. Not me.
You're Spider-Man.
Those are pajamas.
Holy f-
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No, no.
You can't tell anyone, man. If you do, everyone that I love and care about will be put in danger. I just need you to promise me that you will not tell anyone that I'm Spider-Man.
I promise, man. Your secret's safe with me. I gotta ask, man. Why are you doing this?
I could have stopped the guy that killed Uncle Ben, but I didn't. And he always used to say, with great power comes great responsibility. And I have the power to punish the kind of people that took him from me, and it's my responsibility to do so.
With all due respect, man, that doesn't sound like Ben. The guy who killed him. Everybody's talking about how you beat the shit out of him. I mean, it's like a New York folk tale at this point. People love talking about it. How some hero stood up to the scum in this city. But you haven't done that since. Why?
I nearly did it to Mysterio earlier today. Last month I was in such a blind rage I broke some guy's arm. I really hate that side of myself, but I just can't help it. It just comes out every now and then.
But you got your vengeance on the guy. I mean, why still punish people? You're trying to be better, but you let yourself lash out like this. I'm having trouble understanding.
I don't know. You know what?
Like, why am I even telling you about this? You're having trouble understanding. Of course you are! You could never understand what goes on in my mind! We are different people!
My mom was a nervous person. And she didn't like driving. One night, she had dinner plans, and she asked my dad for a drive. He couldn't because he was helping me with homework. So she drove herself, and of course, mom being mom, she drove 5 under the speed limit. Just fast enough for a drunk driver to hit her. I actually blame myself for that. If I hadn't been an idiot and understood my biology homework, Dad would have drove her. She would still be alive. I constantly feel like I'm disappointing him. And everything wrong in his life, it's because of me. I can't forgive myself for that night.
Harry, that's not your fault.
I punish myself every day for my screw-ups. That thing you said about power and responsibility, how you feel morally obligated to punish the kind of people that killed Ben. I think that deep down, you know that you're responsible for the death of Ben. And you can't forgive yourself for it. You're a little too quick to assume that others don't understand how you feel, Peter.
I'm sorry. I didn't know about your mom.
It's okay. Nobody wants to open up anymore. We build these walls to protect ourselves from ever getting hurt again. Who can blame us?
Octavius!
What is it, Quentin? And it better be important.
You know that spider guy that attacked Flint and Herman yesterday?
Yes. What about the Spider-Man?
He came after me. I think he's trying to take us down one by one. He's on to us, Doc.
So what the hell are we gonna do about that?
Yes, the Spider-Man seems to be becoming something of a problem. Call Craven. Tell him we have the perfect prize for him to hunt.
Hello? Hey, Uncle Aaron. Yeah, I got the job. Yeah, I'm starting tomorrow. Yeah, here's to the future, right? All right. Gotta go. My train's about to be here in a second. See you tomorrow.
Join the Spider-Man fan club, free of charge. All you gotta do is pay for the costume. Join the Spider-Man fan club.
Hey, man, what's this?
Oh, it's a Spider-Man fan club for our friendly neighborhood web-slinger.
Oh.
People say he's only a teenager. Can you believe that?
No, really?
It's insane, man. I can't believe this. Like, he's my idol, man. I can't, like, I look up to this guy.
So what kind of events you got planned?
Oh, we're gonna have a big parade on Monday. We're gonna have Spider-Man balloons, a big Spider-Man balloon. It's gonna be amazing, dude. It's gonna be sick.
Okay.
Doesn't mean you're coming?
Do you know where the spider is?
Whoa, man, back up. Listen, I don't know where he is right now, but I know basically everything else about him.
Are you like some sort of supervillain or something?
Patterns, routines, habits. What can I use for my advantage?
I don't feel like dealing with bad guy eyes, asshole.
Spider-Man! Spider-Man! Spider-Man!
Yes, random citizen.
There's some crazy jungle man over here. He got someone hostage. Only let him go if you fight him.
Great.
I feel sorry for you. You're going to witness your hero die at my hands.
I'm sorry, but holding knives to citizens' throats is a no-no in America.
Spider-Man!
Spider-Man, I knew you'd come help me!
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
They call you hero. But do you fit that title? All you do is keep down those struggling. They try to lift themselves out of the hole. But you push them back down. You truly are a vile creature. And I will rid the world of you.
Just unnecessary.
Now I crush you like I crush your leg.
Spider-Man needs my help. Dipshit. Sorry.
Yeah, dude, ya.
You know, without a leopard print, I thought you'd be easier to beat.
You thought wrong!
I knew I couldn't trust you to handle this yourself.
Thanks, Nova!
See you.
Selfie.
Thank you!
Spider-Man. I came here as fast as I could. I called the cops.
Tell them Cruella the villain is knocked out in that alleyway there.
Will do, Mr. Spider-Man.
Please, Mr. Spider-Man's my father's name. Call me Spidey. What's your name, kid?
My name's Miles Morales.
Keep doing the right thing, Miles.
Max Dillon?
Dr. Octavius. What are you doing here?
I heard about your mother, Max. I'm so sorry. Cancer, wasn't it?
Yeah. You see, we couldn't afford treatments anymore. They had to let her go because somebody destroyed my chances of getting a well-paying job.
I'm sorry, Max. But I couldn't let them take my work. My entire life, I have been undermined, ignored, and taken advantage of. When Richards made that announcement... Well, enough was enough. Surely you can understand the pains that this life can inflict upon us.
More than you know. Nobody ever cares about me. This world never cares about me, and they never will. I'm just so tired of it all, because they don't give a fuck!
The world hates people like us, Max. They deal us a bad hand, and then they punish us for playing poorly.
I just can't deal with it anymore. Why does it happen to me? I have nothing left. I have nobody here. I don't know how much more of this I could take.
What if I told you there was a place you could belong? There are others like us, Max. Together, we could thrive off of our shared pain and change this rotten world. A new family.
If what you're telling me is true, where can I find these people?
Let me make some calls.
So, the guy you were fighting today, he was one of those super-powered beings Matt Murdock was talking about?
Well, how do you know about that?
I signed into your email. All the chat logs are right here.
Alright, dude, if you're gonna be my guy in the chair, we gotta go over some privacy and boundary rules.
Anyways, that Craven guy was an assassin from Russia. He's like... the FBI's most wanted guy right now. And Matt Murdock says the power broker, whoever that is, gave Craven a super soldier serum.
Yeah, I know. I've been over this already.
Hey man, I'm catching up. Just making sure I fully understand what's going on. You got some emails from a SHIELD agent.
Oh, okay, that's new. Matt Murdock said that SHIELD agents would be looking into the case. What does the email say?
It's from, Agent Gyrich. He says there's some sightings of another superpowered criminal in Brooklyn.
It must be an older email. I literally just fought that guy.
I don't think so. This guy shoots lightning out of his hands, apparently. And the email is from 15 minutes ago.
I'll be right back.
Man, so he said he wasn't associated with anybody, right? So, you know... I took that money back and I kicked the shit out of him. Left him on the ground for dead, right? What the hell? Yo, man, you better get out of here if you know what's good for you. You can take it.
Such simple minds. I didn't come here for this. I came here for you. Both of you. When was the last time you tried to lend a helping hand? Tried to assist a fellow man? I bet you can't remember, because people like you don't care about anyone except yourselves. And you never will. Spider-Man.
Sorry to be a buzzkill, but I'm pretty sure there's laws against electrocuting people.
I do it to people who deserve it. Why are you trying to save the city, Spider-Man? It's a state filled with nothing but selfishness, pain, and hatred. Nobody is decent anymore. Nobody's worth saving. And no matter how hard you try to be a good person, they'll never follow your example.
Hey, welcome to New York, buddy. It isn't exactly sunshine and rainbows.
What's the point, Spider-Man? You stop one robbery, there's another one happening two blocks away. You clean up the dirt in the city, and it just comes right back into more, worse than ever. You're just in this endless cycle. This place won't get any better. They're too far gone.
Okay, I see you.
Thank you.
Spider-Man, help!
They'll never save them, Spider-Man. They don't want to be saved. Peter? No.
Just wait 1 second. Don't leave quite yet. Round two? By any chance? Get back here. We're not done yet.
It's you. St. Agatha's Hospital is just a block away. If we get him there in time, he may live.
Can you tell you about what happened?
About how he saved Ben's killer? Yeah.
You know if he's okay?
I sure hope so. It took him a lot to do that, and as hard as it was the right thing to do, and I'm just glad he saved them.
Yeah. So when did you find out he was Spider-Man?
Well, he told me right away. Why?
He told you right away? He didn't even tell me. I just found out accidentally.
Oh. Sorry, I think I just said something I wasn't supposed to.
So how does it feel to be a longtime friend of Spider-Man?
It's a pain in the ass, to be honest, but you stick around, and maybe something good will come from it.
Has anything come of it yet?
I'm starting to think we're getting on the right track.
Let me guess! Spider-Man! Damn it! Why won't he just let us be?
We gotta do something about this, Doc. We need to end him right now.
Oh yes, brilliant observation, Quentin. Thank you, I never would have thought of it. Flint! Get Shocker and Kraven here now! We are putting an end to this little pest once and for all.
So we're, killing the Spider-Man?
Hell yeah, we are!
No.
We don't need to kill him. Just remove him from the equation. But if the Spider-Man persists, we may have to swat him permanently. Suit up! Get your powers at the ready and assemble the team. Tonight, we go Spider.
Oh no, I'm late for school.
Yeah, hey. Yeah, he's got the gym. I bet you Parker wouldn't last that long. He's a twig. Oh my gosh. I don't even know how people deal with him. Yeah, I'm on the way. Yeah. If only he knew. Flash.
Hey, McFly! Anyone in there?
You're in Cody's seat.
Cody's not here today.
Still his seat. Don't you think it's kind of rude?
It's just a seat, and all the other ones here are taken.
Well, that just sucks, doesn't it?
Alright, so what you want to do there is isolate the variable. That way, the only thing affected by the equation is the main number there, you know what I mean?
Got it.
Yeah, so the quadratic equations and the quadratic formula. Well, that's me. I gotta go on patrol, man. I'll see you later.
Yeah, later, man. Oh, before you go, I saw this the other day and I wanted to show you.
Oh, well, this is news to me. I wasn't aware I had a fan club.
Apparently. You know what? You could use a confidence boost. Go to your fan club and I'll keep an eye on the police radar and the SHIELD emails. Deal?
Deal. And, of course, my fan club is one person.
Spider-Man? Is that really you, Spider-Man?
Oh, Jesus, not you again.
Are you the real Spider-Man? I need to know. Please tell me.
Yeah, I'm as real as they come, pal.
Oh my God, Spider-Man. My name is Flash Thompson, and I am one of your biggest fans. We've met before. You saved me from that jungle guy. I can't remember his name. It was really cool. Thank you.
Yeah, I remember that. Anyways, I gotta go, before,
You gotta go already? Come on, please stay for a while.
Well, you know, Shocker's probably robbing a bank, Sandman's definitely out there destroying police cars, and I'm dealing with this whole Kraven the Hunter guy now, so, you know.
Parker? Is that you?
I'm sorry, what?
Peter Parker. Is that you under that mask? Are you Spider-Man?
No, I'm not Peter-Man, or Spider-Parker, or whatever you said I was.
You sound just like Parker. You're built just like him. Jeez, you smell just like him, too.
Jeez, do I really smell that bad?
Peter Parker is Spider-Man.
You don't know that.
Holy shit. Holy shit.
Flash. I know we've had our differences in the past, but I really need you to keep this a secret. If word got out that I was Spider-Man, it would put all of my loved ones in danger. Hell, even you'd be put in danger for even associating with me. I need you to understand that. Flash. Do you understand?
Peter, I'm sorry for everything. Everything. I've made your life a living hell since the second grade, and I'm just sorry. I shouldn't have done this. I've made your social life a living hell. And yet, you still saved me from that jungle guy.
Yeah?
Spider-Man's my hero. He symbolizes everything someone should be. He's humble, he looks out for the little guy, he does all the right things. And I bullied him for years.
Flash?
I hope you know, I only picked on you because I was jealous of you.
You, Flash Thompson, Party King, jealous of me.
Don't be like that about it, Parker, come on. You were smart. You were good at school. Everyone liked you. And for a long time, no one liked me. And I guess I took that out on you. And I shouldn't have. But you're my hero. You're Spider-Man.
Listen, I'm not as cool as you think I am, believe me.
Oh, shut up, Parker. You're Spider-Man, goddammit. The greatest superhero ever on Earth. The Daily Bugle might not see that, and the haters might not see that, but I do.
Okay, where is the old Flash, and what did you do with him?
If I had my time back, I wouldn't have said those things, and I wouldn't have done what I did.
Well, unfortunately, you can't change the past.
I can change the future, though. Peter, you're Spider-Man. If anyone knows anything about being good, it's you. Do you think you can teach me?
I mean, yeah, if you would like.
I'd like that.
Flash, you're not gonna tell anyone about this, right?
Yeah, I promise.
Hey, Flash. I forgive you for everything.
Oh, thank you. Hey, you go save the city. New York will learn to appreciate you like I do.
Nice hat, by the way.
Pete, there's been supervillains spotted in an industrial park in Queens. Hurry!
Some loyal customers. Wouldn't you agree, Spider-Man?
Dr. Octavius, I should have known you were behind this. So you're the power broker, huh?
Yes, I suppose you could call me the architect, the master planner, the engineer of this entire operation. This is all my doing.
Well, I gotta say, 6 versus 1? Not exactly a fair fight.
The world isn't fair, Spider-Man. But you might find that I can. I'll give you what this world never gave any of us. A chance. Leave now. Walk away and never interfere with us again. And we'll let you keep your life.
No. No, I don't think I will.
Very well, Spider-Man. Cling to your ideas. Gentlemen, carry on.
Hit me.
When did we all agree on killing him?
Well, if we don't kill him, he's gonna keep trying to stop us. Doc?
We gave him an opportunity to leave. As far as I'm concerned, his life is forfeit.
We're not killing him. He's only 17.
How do you know how old he is? Do you know him?
Explain! Now! Gentlemen! Gentlemen! Calm down.
He was the only person who was ever nice to me.
I'm out. I'm not killing anyone, let alone a kid. I already got my money. But I only stayed because I was too scared to say no. But now I am saying no. Come on, Herman.
I ain't letting them kill some kid, Flint.
I'm not asking for permission.
Gentlemen, please!
You're not killing a kid.
Just watch us.
I'm warning you, Windex.
All I hear is da 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 da. Enough talk! Ow! No! No! No!
Ah! Hey, you all right, kid?
I
back for a second there. You're not beating me up. What did I miss?
You missed the part where I hit him in the head with the shovel. And don't worry about it.
Where's Octavius?
I don't know. Check the garage.
All right.
See? Das Vidania!
Now go on, kid. We got this guy.
Thank you. Should have saw that coming.
Just like old times, huh?
Hang on! Hang on!
Alright, so, this is the garage, but I am missing my evil octopus guy. Where did he go? Come on, Pete, he's a giant octopus. You really can't lose him that easily, can you? Hello! Any big evil scientists in the building? Where are you two? I got a bad feeling about this. Dr. Octopus.
Always in the way! I've had enough of your meddling, Spider-Man! You die here! Now!
Otto Octavius. I should be shocked, but quite frankly, I'm not. Sorry I had to break up your little boy band there. Seems like that took a hassle to put together, Master Planner.
You turned them against one another. We were united. A family of unwanted members of society. But you took that from me. Everything gets taken from me!
Well, maybe if you weren't a mechanical cyborg octopus egomaniac, then that wouldn't happen.
What happened to me wasn't my fault. Society won't give me a damn break, Spider-Man!
Yeah? Well, creating a team of evil supervillains isn't exactly a healthy coping method.
But I didn't create them. The world did. Yes, I may have helped Mysterio, Sandman, and Electro develop their abilities. But I never kidnapped Shocker's family. I wasn't the cancer that burned through Sandman's daughter, and I didn't exile Kraven from his homeland. This world takes and takes, and it never gives. And nobody cares. How much am I expected to take before I say enough is enough?
That's a nice speech there, Doc. How about you go tell it to the commissioner?
How ignorant of me to expect you to listen. Well, I guess it ends here now, Spider-Man.
Spider-Man, you'd only stayed out of my way. Now, you will die.
Stop!
What?
Electro. He's too dangerous. His ratings are off the charts. His powers can rival Thor. Tell me everything you know about him.
The suit. The suit grounds him. Without it, the use of his electrical powers would burn that traitor's body to a crisp. Destroy the suit, and you'll get rid of your little Electro problem.
I'm not going to kill him.
What then? Spider-Man saves another lost soul? You really think you can save this rotten city? You're delusional. The pursuit of good in this world will get you nowhere. My hypothesis? You'll end up depressed or dead. Knowing you, probably the latter.
Yeah. Good talk, Doc Ock.
Otto never cared for me. He lied! All I want is for someone to care. I can make them care. I will. They will know what it's like to feel the pain I feel.
You know, you could have knocked. What happened today, kid?
Come on, I think I did pretty good today, alright? I took down 5 out of the 6 supervillains.
You took them down? Funny you should mention that. After they all got caught, each of them said they'd beat the shit out of you until they turned on each other.
Did they say it like that?
You've been pulling your punches, too.
Herman Schultz and Flint Marco. What's going to happen to them?
Chakra and Sandman? I'm thinking life in prison, without parole. The public will feel a lot safer with those superpowered beings behind bars.
Come on, that's not right and you know it. Yes, if they killed somebody or were people like Kraven and Mysterio, then yeah, I'd understand life in prison without parole, but... How do you feel about this as a lawyer, huh?
You know something, kid? A few decades ago, 2 gods went to war in our Barry City. Thousands died, blocks were leveled, New York has not recovered since. These people have every right to be afraid. Yes, I'm willing to cross some ethical lines, but it's a small price to pay to ease the minds of the masses. Fear rules this city, kid. People fear what they don't understand.
But you gotta admit, this doesn't feel right. I mean, come on, Flint Marco's daughter has cancer. Herman Schultz's family is being held for ransom. Surely we can do better.
When I recruited you for this mission, I expect you to be tough, to act without restraint, to show the people of New York that these superpowered beings are nothing to fear. And you've disappointed me. Hell, you've lost more fights than you've won. Not only that, but judging by how you're talking, you're acting like you're trying to sympathize with these villains, trying to understand them. You're trying to sympathize with the people who killed your uncle, Peter.
But there's a line. Yes, the guy who killed my uncle's a monster. But Herman Schultz isn't. Flint Marco isn't. Hell, even Octavius got screwed over. We can't just generalize and put them into these categories. Their deeds don't justify ours.
Oh, yeah? Where's the Spider-Man that sent Dennis Garrity into the ICU for months? That's the Spider-Man that this city needs.
I don't want to be that Spider-Man anymore. Since Uncle Ben died, I've been so angry all the time! As much as I like to stand here and tell you that I put on that suit for noble causes, that I put on that suit to go out and save innocent lives and defend the good people of New York, I really did it to justify taking my anger out on the kind of people that killed him. You know, I never really admitted that until now. Deep down, I know his death is my fault. And I just can't forgive myself for that. But I know that I need to let this anger go. I cannot let it rule me anymore.
No, you don't. Let it drive you. Let it fuel your resolve.
No, you're wrong! This world, it needs a better hero. And I didn't think I could do it, but I can give the world that. Ever since I put on the mask, I've been filled with nothing but hate and anger towards myself for letting him die. I can't change my past. But I can change my future.
I'm taking you out of the case. I got it from here. Thanks for your help, Spider-Man.
What made you quit being Daredevil? What made you hang it up? Yeah. Matthew Murdock. The Daredevil. You know, there's not a whole lot of blind vigilantes in New York. You were the guardian of this city. You were the devil of Hell's Kitchen. What happened?
I got soft. Let my guard down. Tried to be happy. In a world like this, Peter, that's just asking to be punished. I lost everything I loved. The anger and the fear keeps me safe now. I don't want you to lose what I've lost. I'd love to be happy again, be a wishful thinker, a good Samaritan, but we live in an unforgiving world. It's better to be afraid, angry, and safe than shattered and sorry.
Then Moses stretched out his staff towards heaven, and the Lord sent thunder and hail, and fire ran down to the earth, and the Lord rained hail upon the land of Egypt.
I see it rise. You want to stop me, and I know why. It's because of who I am. You know exactly who I am. You know.
Who are you? Who are you?
You know.
Save this world. What has it done for us? We were right, but you changed. Why?
I was wrong. And so are you.
As God strikes down the sinners, Judgment Day is nigh. When it happens, you'll want to be on the right side.
Yesterday, the infamous Spider-Man apprehended the newly dubbed Dr. Octopus, and my PR guy wants me to thank him. Well, I won't. I'm a true-blooded American who believes in free speech. I will not be silenced just to appeal to some PR agenda. Gentlemen, it appears as if New York is experiencing some sort of lightning storm above the city. Now, the Daily Bugle report strongly encourages you to stay inside and stay safe. As of right now, we have no intel on what is the culprit behind the attack, but most likely it is that menace, Spider-Man.
Electro! Stop!
Leave me alone!
I don't think I can do that, buddy. You're kind of blowing up my neighborhood here.
Peter, please.
What did you just say?
Leave, Peter. I don't want to hurt you.
Max, how could you do this? Why?
This world doesn't give a shit anymore, Peter. Every day we see people hurting. We see people dying. People just step right over them. This world's become numb. Nobody cares about their neighbor anymore. And they never cared about me? They never cared about my family?
You think destroying a city is gonna make people care about you?
Not me. I'm gonna be blamed for this. And they're gonna be right, but I'm gonna give this world something that they never even knew they needed. I'm creating a great tragedy. Through shared losses and shared pain, this world is gonna start to wake up, and people are gonna start to care about each other. They're gonna know what their neighbor's feeling because they felt the exact same thing. I have good intentions here, Peter.
But Max, you could kill thousands!
You might call it a heavy price. I don't think so myself. I'd call them the lucky ones. I'm freeing them from this pain, this torture, this hell on Earth that we've created for ourselves. Everybody else will feel their loss and understand the pain. Slowly, they're gonna start to wake up, and then they'll understand.
Max, please just talk to me.
Get out of my way!
I gotta take that suit off.
That thing you said about power and responsibility, how you feel morally obligated to punish the kind of people that killed Ben, I think that deep down, you know that you're responsible for the death of Ben. You can't forgive yourself for it. Nobody wants to open up anymore. We build these walls to protect ourselves from ever getting hurt again. Who can blame us?
Look, I know the guilt can be tough to carry, but the only person that can forgive you is yourself.
This world takes and takes, and it never gives, and nobody cares.
I can't change my past.
I can change the future, though.
There's so much pain in this world. Don't add to it. Be the hero this world deserves, Peter.
Come on, man. I need this.
It's okay, Peter. I forgive you. But now, you just need to learn to forgive yourself.
I care.
What?
I've always cared about you, man. You're my friend.
Shut up.
Max, people care. I care.
I said shut up!
You matter, Max. I know sometimes it feels like the world is against you, but you're not alone, man. There are many others just like you.
Just shut up!
Life gets better, Max. I know that sometimes the world won't give us a reason to keep going, but we need to find it ourselves. Just keep holding out hope, man. You're my brother, man. I've always cared.
They'll never care, man. They never cared about me. about my mom, about my dad, about anybody. If I do this, man, then maybe they'll finally feel what I feel.
People do hurt, all in different ways. But they move on. They become something more, something better. They take that pain and put it someplace positive.
Oh, like you? Because the moment you got your powers, you put on that damn mask and went hunting down Ben's killer. Hurting people, breaking bones on this pointless path of vengeance. And you want to tell me how to handle my pain?
I was wrong. But Ben always said, with great power comes great responsibility. And I believe what he meant by that is, everybody on this planet has the power to help one another. And that's why we gotta be there for each other.
Like you were for me? Because the moment you put on that damn mask, you were too busy saving cats out of trees to even think about me. I meant nothing to you, Peter. You're just saying that.
Max, I'm sorry. But I promise you, I will be here for you from now on. Whatever you need, I got you. Just take off the armor, please. Let's go get you some help. You ready to start over?
Yeah, man. Hey, Peter?
Yeah?
Thank you.
No problem, buddy. Come on.
How's the people versus the Electro case coming along?
I didn't come up with the name, kid.
Well, I'm just still grateful you agreed to be his defense attorney. Thanks again, man.
I don't think it's a secret that I didn't want to. But you were adamant that I gave Max a shot. You almost killed yourself trying to talk him down. You believed in the good of Max so much that you were willing to die. I guess I had to give it a shot myself.
Is the case going well, at least?
I won't get your hopes up, kid. The jury's terrified of him. Best case scenario, 10 years, chances of parole, and court-mandated therapy sessions.
Okay, and what's the worst case scenario?
Life in prison without parole. The jury is leaning more toward that alternative, given the property damage done by his lightning.
Here.
What's this?
Well, it's a little file I put together about Flint Marco and Herman Schultz. It has everything in there. Herman's rough upbringing, his family situation, everything about Flint's daughter.
So, you want me to defend these guys too?
Yeah. I think it's about time New York gets a good lawyer. I'll see you around. Oh, and, up to you, of course, but I think New York could always use its protector back.
Well, if you ask me, I think they already got a pretty damn good one.
As New Yorkers, we cannot allow this to happen again. We're lucky Electro didn't kill anyone with his storm. But how long will it be before the next Electro comes and takes lives? Or the next two-bit thug mugs your grandmother? Or the next hoodlum breaks into your home? With Oscorp security drones, we are going to chase criminals out of the city. We will also raise the cost of living in at-risk areas. Hard-working, blue-collar Americans will earn their place, while the rest are forced to leave with their tail between their legs. It's time to put your foot down, New York, and here to back me on this is your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. $100,000, Spider-Man. All you gotta do is give old Norm the thumbs up.
You got it, Mr. Osborn?
It's gonna be Mayor Osborn soon. You got this.
Hey guys, I'm Spider-Man.
Everyone is the hero to their own story. We constantly believe we're in the right, we prioritize our own agendas, and we label those who contradict our agendas as villains. After the recent attacks, I'm sure most of you guys are terrified right now. And I'm sure Mr. Osborn's plan to fight crime sounds very appealing. But I've heard you all talk about how you want to rid these monsters from New York. But what if I told you that these monsters have a lot more in common with us than you might think? You know the Sandman? Flint Marco robbed banks to pay off hospital bills for his daughter with cancer. Or the Shocker, who stole money because some mob boss was holding his family for ransom. Electro. Max Dillon. He lost everything, and all he wanted was someone to care. If we were there for these people, instead of pushing them into a corner and shunning them from the world, then maybe the attacks this week wouldn't have happened at all. We need to be there for one another. Instead of condemning others, we need to take responsibility for once. No matter what vengeance's hate and fear lies within, we need to learn to forgive others and forgive ourselves. New York is built on discrimination, fear, corruption, and ignorance. This city needs people to stop and help out a neighbor, rather than climb over them to obtain their own peace. Instead of filling your mind with fears and intolerance, fill it with an idea of greatness to strive towards. We can't stop crime with kindness, I know that. But if we rebuild our foundation as a society, then maybe we can decrease the risk of future crimes. Don't label people. Learn to understand them. Learn to help these people get out of the rut they're in. We're all in the same boat. We all have our own demons to face. So let's face these demons together. We're all more alike than you think. Yes, I'm well aware that absolutely sinister people exist who won't be stopped with just acceptance and understanding. But as a people, we can't allow that. Which is why we need more people who are willing to stand up to these bullies. We are all the heroes of our own stories, and you'd be surprised how many of our villains aren't beyond redemption. Accept your downfalls and help others to do the same. I've been rambling for a while, so I'll wrap this up quickly. We don't need to keep being afraid, and instead of punishing those struggling, let's try to understand them. We all have the power to do so, and it's our responsibility. That is why I am not endorsing Mr. Osborn for mayor. This city needs better. We deserve better. Thank you.
Sorry, Norman. Maybe next year.
Hey, what's up, Cuba Parker? Where did you want me to put the box?
The old DVR players? I think May wanted those in the front porch.
Alright.
Hey, Flash. Thanks again, man.
So, how you holding up?
I'm doing alright, Gwen. I just wanted to say that you were right. I became Spider-Man in order to punish the kind of people that took Ben from me. It was catharsis after his death, and I think I was just too scared to confront the fact that I'm the one responsible for his death. I wanted to blame the kind of people that killed him so badly, but I'm the only person to blame. You know, I thought it'd be a lot harder to accept. I didn't think I'd be able to accept it, but, well, here I am. And thanks to you, thanks to everybody, I know what kind of hero I need to be now.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. Mainly because now I get to say, I told you so.
Yes, yes, I know.
God, I am so happy that you're going to be a better Spider-Man now. Like, Peter, you have no idea how morally wrong your actions were. It was almost comically bad in a way.
Yeah, beating up a guy whose daughter had cancer isn't exactly one of my proudest moments.
I mean, in your defense, that guy did have Saiyan power, so I doubt he felt anything. Pep talk over, let's start moving those boxes.
Yeah, sounds good. How would you feel about dinner sometime?
Like, a date?
I mean, it could be whatever you want it to be.
First of all, you are totally not my type. You dress up in tights for a living. It's why I was doing my body shit.
I'm thinking maybe I should thank you. Oh, baby, I should buy you another round. Cause you care and I swear that I'm here, but I'm there. It's getting harder to hunt me down. Get away to a place where the lake's such a great view. Leave the bank couple hundred down. I made it, but hey, once I build it, I break it. That might just break me down. All I ever needed was somebody with some reason who can keep me sane. Ever since I can't remember, I've been keeping it together, but I'm feeling strange. Get away when it ain't really safe and it don't seem right. But what's new, you get used to the bullshit. Screws, they go missing. It's likely they might be, but no. Minus the problems that I attract, and half the time the wheels is in the back of my mind. Just keep on turning till the tires flat and burn until the fire crack. I do not lie, though facts may seem a little far-fetched. That's only cause I may be make-believe and full of darkness. When I'm stuck between a rock and a hard place, walking, dropping change inside your empty guitar case. That's charity, I move carelessly, that's why I'm always tripping. I guess it's like electrolytes, you help me go the distance. Not too efficient, but the way it's always been, until the day we have to meet again. Get away when it ain't really safe and it don't seem right. But what's new, you get used to the bullshit. The screws, they go missing. It's likely they might be, but
so, Peter, what do you think of this red?
It's a bit of a darker red. I prefer my red a little bit brighter. It's a little woolly, too. What do you think, Gwen? Gwen? You good?
Hey, you might want to check this out. When interrogating Silvio Manfredi, the 45-year-old Don claimed that it was none other than the Green Goblin that attacked his facility. A green-clad monster that hasn't been seen in over 15 years. The NYPD is warning citizens to stay safe, and if they know any information about the Green Goblin, to please pass it along.
The Green Goblin? Isn't that the guy who killed all the Magia Dons back in 05?
Yeah. Yeah, that's him.
Well, I know who you're going after next. Come on, bro. Let's go get that new suit finished.
Yeah. You alright?
Yeah, it's just, this guy is beyond messed up. His kill count is in like the double digits, and no one knows who he is. And the amount of tech he has access to, I think he might be a little bit out of our league.
Listen, just try not to think about it. I mean, he hasn't been around in over a decade. He's probably out of practice. Just don't worry about it. I promise you we'll be fine, okay?
Okay.
Hello. Excuse me, sir. So sorry to interrupt. Sir, tonight's transaction was compromised. We didn't get the money. The buyer fled the scene. We were interrupted by him. The Spider-Man. This is the second time he's interfered. I fear he might be on to us, sir. Sir?
This Spider-Man, does he truly think he could stop us?
I believe so, sir.
If he really thinks he can make a difference, he's dangerously wrong. We won't be stopped. We cannot be stopped. Especially by a child who dresses up and pretends to be an Avenger. So what do you propose we do about this?